Right, it's recording.
Right,
excellent.
Thank you, Becky.
You're very welcome.
How did you think you played?
I think I played exceptionally well.
Why do you think that?
The way I was dribbling, the way I passed the ball, shot.
Would you say it was one of your better games?
Yeah, I think it was alright.
What was the outcome of the game? Did you win or did you lose?
Well, when you're in the emotion and the zone of the game, you can't forget to score, but at the end it went wrong.
Why do you think that was the outcome?
Both teams were kind of strong, but we just couldn't get the ball in the back then.
How do you think you as a team played?
I think we played good, yeah. Kept the ball.
Coming up against a Spanish opposition and Manchester City's playing style is passing, and Sevilla's is passing. Do you think you cancelled each other out because you have the same philosophy?
Yeah, we kind of were clashed, but after a while, true quality shows through, and we just.
So you'd say you're stronger?
Yeah, you're stronger. I'm not physically better.
Was there any point in the game where you lost focus? If so, why do you think this happened?
Yeah, when they scored, we kind of lost a bit of focus. It threw us off a bit more. It's more because of that we could get knocked out of the tournament if we lose.
Do you get nervous before a game? If so, how do you deal with your nerves?
Yeah, before a game, I get kind of nervous. I just listen to some music and it calms me down.
If you didn't do this before the game, do you think it would have a negative effect on the way you performed?
Yeah, I don't think I'd be ready for the game if I don't listen to any songs.
Before the game, do you visualise your performance?
Yeah, actually I've got a few clips on my phone where of past performances, so I just watch them back.
Do these clips arouse you?
Yeah, they get me very happy. Gives me confidence.
What is your plan now to improve your performance?
My plan? Just work hard every day in training and watch videos back of things I can't do well and just work on it.
Do certain situations increase your arousal with us?
Yeah, situations like if we've just scored a goal, I get kind of happy. And if someone's made a good tackle or a good save, things like that.
Do you get more arousal than your family and friends or in the crowd watching a game?
Yeah, I feel more happy to show that they're supporting me and that they're there watching the game.
Do you have any superstitions before the game?
Yeah, I like to do a double knot in my left trainer, but not on my right.
How should you participate in the game?
Pardon?
How
should
you participate in the game?
I think, me personally, yeah, I think I did well. I was strong through the game, attacking, defensive, yeah, I think it was good.
How do you motivate yourself before a game?
Yeah, there's this clip I watch back, but like, it questions you. It makes you think about what you're good at, what you're not good at, and that you should never give up.
Level change before a match than it does when it's half time?
Yeah, before the game I'm kind of nervous, but at half time the nerves have kind of gone. I'm just focused on winning the game.
How do you keep your tension levels high throughout the whole of the game?
I try not to think about other things. I just irrelevant to football. Just try to stay focused on football.
Your family or friends are in the crowd. Does this make you lose concentration or does it make you want to work harder?
Slightly at the start of the game, I'm thinking about like what they're doing and who's there, but during the game I think about just impressing them and working hard, showing them what I've got.
By doing that, do you think you play for yourself or the team?
Not really for myself. I think I play for the team when family comes to show that I'm not selfish.
During the match, if the opposition scored a goal, how does it affect your attention?
I think it will focus it even more and just think about scoring goals.
On a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being highest, how would you say your attention levels was throughout the whole game?
I think it was a 9. 9 being because there was a lot of people in the crowd, kind of threw me off a bit, but it was fine.
If you had a bad night's sleep, would you feel nervous before the game?
Not really nervous, I just feel tired and just slow. Yeah, so.
Do you think this would have a negative effect on your performance?
Yeah, because I won't be sharp in the game at the start, I'll be just kind of sloppy.
Do internal factors, for example the crowd, have an effect on your anxiety levels?
Yeah, if the crowd's kind of noisy, I'm just thinking about if I get a ball, what I'm going to do, if I lose it.
If you were to play an away game and the crowd was booming the team as you come on, would that have a negative effect on the way you perform?
Not really, it'd have a positive effect just to show them that like, they shouldn't be booming the way. It's embarrassing.
Do you feel more anxious before playing a Champions League game compared to playing a normal league game?
Yeah, because Champions League games, there's more at stake. If you lose, you're out. Yeah.
If the manager put you on the bench, how would you deal with this mentally?
I'd be disappointed at first, but my disappointment would turn to anger, which I'll show through performances, which might be a positive.
So this will make you try and prove him?
Yeah.
If you got took off and then went back on, would you think you played better or do you think it would have a negative effect?
Yeah, I think I played better just to prove to him that I shouldn't have took me off. Yeah, I made the wrong decision.
How do you normally control your feelings of being anxious before a game?
I was told just to take slow breaths on count to 10. That kind of calms me down.
Do you feel you were prepared before the game, and why do you think that?
Yeah, I thought I was ready because the night before I had a good meal, had a good sleep, so yeah, I felt ready. So if that's not the problem.